Everybody, welcome to this session on the computation of moment. So mathematical definition of moment is it is force into corresponding perpendicular distance. So when I mention force, it will be a two direction force, either a force parallel to x direction or force parallel to y direction. If we happen to have a force parallel to x direction, that is if the force has to be in the horizontal direction, then the perpendicular distance that we need to consider is the vertical distance, which is y direction. Likewise, if we happen to have a force parallel to y direction, then the perpendicular distance that we need to consider is the perpendicular distance along the x direction. So we need to look at the individual force component, whether it is a force component parallel to x or force component parallel to y. If we happen to have a force component parallel to x, then it is essential to multiply y coordinate, which will be a perpendicular distance for fx force component. Likewise, if we happen to have a y direction force component, we need to look at the x coordinate, which will be a perpendicular distance for the y direction force component. So it is essential to note down the x coordinate and y coordinate at whichever location a force has been placed. Now if I happen to consider a grid which has various quantities of forces of different magnitudes, and this is a grid of dimension 1 meter along the x direction and 1 meter along the y direction. This is an example that we are going to consider to calculate the moment with respect to a given moment center. Then it has been subjected to a horizontal force of 15 kN, a vertical force of 20 kN. Then in addition to that, it also has an inclined force component of magnitude 10 kN. The force, this particular force of 10 kN subtends an angle of 30 degrees with respect to the vertical face. That means if it has a face along the vertical direction, 10 kN is been placed along the inclined direction, subtending an angle of 30 degrees with respect to the vertical face or vertical y-axis. Now here, we are supposed to find out the moment with respect to a given moment center. If I happen to name A, B, C and D as the prominent points on this particular grid, I shall start to consider the moment with respect to the various location. Now as the moment center goes on varying, moment center means it is origin. As moment center goes on varying, automatically the origin will also vary. If I mention A as the moment center, in that situation, A will be the origin. On the other hand, for the next case, if I happen to mention B as the origin, B will be the moment center and origin should be considered with reference to point B. So origin in the sense, it, the coordinate will be 0, 0. To begin with, I shall consider to find moment with respect to A, moment with respect to A point. So when I mention moment with respect to A point, as stated earlier, A will be an origin, wherein at origin coordinates will be 0, 0. So if I happen to mention the coordinate here as 0, 0, all horizontal direction will be x and all vertical direction shall be y. We shall note down the forces which have been given in the statement of the problem. The forces has been mentioned here, one horizontal force on this vertical face, which is of magnitude 15 kN. Then further 20 kN force has been placed here. Then we have an inclined force component. Now coming on to this particular inclined force component, as mentioned a few minutes before, we need to have a force component either parallel to x direction or parallel to y direction. Now in this particular given statement of the problem, this 10 kN force is an inclined force component. So for that reason, we need to resolve this particular force component, which will have its force component either parallel to y or parallel to x. So if this particular angle has been given as 30 degrees, total inclination between x and y is 90 degrees, and the remaining angle left subtended with respect to x-axis shall be 60 degrees. That is 90 minus 30 shall be 60 degrees. The resolution of this particular force component, that is 10 kN force component, with respect to 60 degrees, it will have a vertical force component as 10 sine of 60 and horizontal force component as 10 cos of 60 degrees. So these are the two force components which will be either parallel to x direction and parallel to y direction. The main contention of considering this particular force either parallel to x and parallel to y direction is so that perpendicular distance multiplication will be very very easy. If I happen to have an x component force, my only next contention is to find out if I consider x component force, then what shall be the y coordinate that I need to consider for multiplication. Likewise, if I happen to consider 10 sine 60, which is a vertical y component force, for this vertical y component force, I need to multiply x coordinate. I need to note down what will be the x coordinate at that particular junction where the force is being subtended. I shall mark this particular force component on this particular free body diagram. If I happen to mark, it will have an horizontal x component as 10 cos of 60 degrees and vertical y component as 10 sine of 60 degrees. This will be the resolution of the force component to ensure that all the forces which have been displayed on the lamina are either parallel to y direction or parallel to x direction, so that the multiplication distance and the computation of the moment will be very easy. If I consider this as the origin, point A as the origin, contention for considering point A as the origin is because I am considering moment with respect to A. Whichever point I am going to mention here, that is moment with respect to A or moment with respect to B, the location indicates that will be the origin or the moment center. So A will be the moment center, which is nothing but the origin. At a origin, where x and y axis meet, the coordinate will be 0, 0. Moving further ahead, distance here is 0.5 from the top fiber, which indicates 15 kN from the bottom fiber shall be 0.5. Reason, total height of the vertical face is 1 meter, and from that if we subtract 0.5 meter, remaining left out height will be 0.5 meter. The coordinate at this particular location will be, x will be 0, y will be 0.5. Do remember, this will be x coordinate, which is 0, y coordinate will be 0.5. Then for 20 kN force, which has been placed at the center, if I happen to place it at the center, that is at a distance of 1 meter from the either side, the coordinate at this particular location will be 1, comma, x will be 1 meter because from the origin it is 1 meter. Along the vertical direction it will be 1, comma, 1. Then at this particular location wherein the 10 kN force has been placed and which has been resolved along the vertical component and horizontal component, the coordinate at this particular location will be, x coordinate will be 2 meter because total base of this particular lamina is 2 meter, and y coordinate will be 0.5 because both are parallel to each other, so y coordinate shall remain same. So what we can observe here is, we have two force components, 10 sine 60 and 10 cos 60. When I am considering 10 sine 60, 10 sine 60 is a y component force and I need to multiply x coordinate, and x coordinate been written here is 2. So 10 sine 60 which shall be multiplied with 2, whereas 10 cos 60, which is an x component force and which will be multiplied with y coordinate, which is 0.5. So these are nothing but the perpendicular distance and the individual force component. If I write down straight away moment with respect to A, it will be x component force. X component force will be multiplied with y coordinate, and by looking at this particular coordinate which has been written, y coordinate is 0.5. So it will be 15 into 0.5. Task is not yet over. Reason here, we need to demarcate the direction of rotation. Just to have a differentiation between the clockwise direction rotation and anti-clockwise direction, we need to adopt a sign convention. Sign convention that we are going to adopt here is all clockwise direction rotation to be positive. It is all clockwise direction rotation to be positive and all anti-clockwise direction rotation to be negative. So considering that particular condition, with respect to point A has been placed at the bottom fiber, 15 kN force is towards the left hand side. If I happen to pull it or push it towards the left hand side, we shall rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. So anti-clockwise is negative, so this will be minus 15 into 0.5. So again I shall repeat, minus sign has been adopted just because 15 kN force with reference to point A shall rotate in anti-clockwise direction, so that's why it is minus 15 into 0.5. 20 kN force which has been placed on the top fiber with reference to A It is in the downward direction, so it shall rotate in clockwise direction. So direction of rotation in the clockwise direction is positive. Plus, magnitude of the force is 20. And this 20 force is a force parallel to Y. Whereas 15 was a force parallel to X. And when it is a force parallel to X, I multiplied Y coordinate. Now when it is a force parallel to Y, I shall multiply X coordinate. And X coordinate here is 1. So 20 into 1. Then the last inclined force component, which has been resolved along vertical force component and horizontal force component. Vertical force component with reference to A is downward, so it shall rotate in clockwise direction. So plus 10 sine 60. And again, as mentioned, we need to look at what particular direction the force parallel to. 10 sine 60 is a force parallel to Y direction. And we need to multiply X coordinate, and X coordinate is 2. So into 2. Likewise, with reference to A, 10 cos 60 is towards the right hand side. 15 when it was towards the left hand side, it tried to rotate the lamina in the anti-clockwise direction. So that's the reason why you consider this as negative. On the other hand, 10 cos 60 is towards the right hand side. When it rotates, it shall rotate in the clockwise direction. So clockwise direction rotation is positive. 10 cos 60 into X component force, so multiply with Y coordinate, which is nothing but 0.5. So this will be the force component and its individual perpendicular distance. 10 sin 60 is Y component force, so you are going to multiply X coordinate. Whereas 10 cos 60 is X component force, so you are going to multiply Y coordinate. So these are the individual forces and its perpendicular distance. Now next task is to substitute in the calculator and look at what will be the final solution. And then come to a conclusion. Whether all these net forces will create a clockwise direction rotation or anti-clockwise direction rotation. It all depends upon what will be the sign convention that we are going to get after the addition of all the magnitude force that we have considered. So here, minus 15 into 0.5, 20 into 1, 10 sine 60 into 2, plus 10 cos 60 into 0.5. The cumulative solution will come out as 32.32 as the value. Now if you happen to observe, 32.32 is a positive value. Positive value means the direction of rotation will be in clockwise direction. So 32.32 will be the magnitude of rotation force that will be induced with reference to point A. And since it is positive, direction of rotation, that means the grid or the lamina shall rotate in the clockwise direction. So this is what is the value of moment that we are going to arrive when we consider with reference to A. And per clockwise direction is considered because the summation value comes out to positive. That's why we are considering it to be a clockwise direction. All clockwise direction to be positive and all anti-clockwise direction to be negative. So it is just an assumption and just a demarcation that we need to make. There is no hard and fast rule that all clockwise has to be positive and all anticlockwise has to be negative. Some textbooks even follow the reverse order. Reverse order in the sense, all clockwise may be considered as negative and all anticlockwise can be considered as positive. Only care that we need to take here is, if I am adopting clockwise to be positive, it is very much essential to look at all anticlockwise has to be in the anticlockwise direction. That is, negative sign should be adopted for the anticlockwise direction. So this is what is the calculation for moment with respect to point A. Same problem we shall consider for the calculation with respect to point B. So to find out moment with respect to B, I shall redraw the grid again and then check out what will be the magnitude of moment with respect to point B. To find moment with respect to B. If I find out moment with respect to B, I shall draw this particular grid again. Total base of the grid is 2 meter and height of the grid is 1 meter. Everything shall remain same, magnitude of the force shall remain same, dimension will remain same. Only change that we are going to observe here is the origin location. First case, origin was considered with reference to A. When origin was considered with reference to A, at A coordinate was considered as 0,0 because moment was considered with respect to A. Now since I am considering moment with respect to B, So origin will be located at B and coordinate at that particular location will be 0, 0. Rest all, the position of the force, magnitude of the force shall be kept same. So 20 kN force been placed on the top fiber shall be kept same. 15 kN towards the left hand side shall be kept same. Then an inclined force component, which is 10 kN force component. After resolution, we had two force component, vertical force component and horizontal force component. Horizontal force component was 10 cos 60 and vertical force component was 10 sin of 60 degree. So these are the force component that we are going to get after being placed at the individual location. So with reference to this particular point B, coordinate at A now, that is coordinate at 20 kN force. The coordinate shall not be same, reason, origin is different. So for that reason, probability the distance will also vary depending upon the location where the origin has been placed. So with reference to the point B, coordinate under 20 kN load, x value will be 1, y value will be 0. Earlier it was 1, 1, now it will be 1, 0. Difference here is the moment was considered with reference to A and the moment shall be considered with reference to B. For that reason, coordinates will be different based upon the direction where the origin is to be considered. Then, with reference to the same origin, coordinate at 15 kN load will be 0, 0.5. Then, the location where 10 sin 60 and 10 cos 60 has been placed, coordinate at this particular location will be 2, 0.5. So these are the coordinates that we are going to note down. So 2 is x coordinate, 0.5 is y coordinate, and here x is 1 coordinate and y is 0, whereas at 15 kN load x is 0 and y will be 0.5. After this we need to look out what particular coordinate shall be multiplied with respect to the individual forces. So with reference to B, 20 kN load shall be multiplied. 20 kN load is force parallel to Y. Now when I write down the equation here, it shall be written as MB. Earlier it was written as MB because it was moment with respect to A. Now it is a moment with respect to B, so expression will be written as MB is equal to. 20 is a Y component force which shall be multiplied with X coordinate and X coordinate is 1. So 20 into 1. Now with reference to point A, or with reference to B, 20 is acting in the downward direction which will rotate in clockwise direction. So plus 20 into 1. 15 with reference to B is towards the left hand side which will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Which will rotate in clockwise direction. With reference to B, 15 is towards the left hand side which will rotate in clockwise direction. Clockwise direction is positive. 15 into X component force, 15 is an X component force, so you are going to multiply Y coordinate and Y coordinate is 0.5. So this will be an expression for 15 kN force. Then 10 sin 16, with reference to B, 10 sin 60 is downward. So with reference to B, B is on the left hand side, 10 sin 60 is downward here. If I push it downward, it will rotate in clockwise direction, so positive 10 sin 60 multiply by perpendicular distance. 10 sin 60 is a Y component force and you are going to multiply X coordinate. X coordinate is 2. So 10 sin 60 shall be multiplied with 2. Likewise with reference to point B, 10 cos 60 is towards the right hand side which will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So minus 10 cos 60 into, it's X component force, so multiplied with Y coordinate which will be 0.5. So these are nothing but the individual forces and its perpendicular distance. We need to look out what particular direction this particular lamina will try to rotate. So if we write down or express this particular and substitute in the calculator, 20 into 1 plus 15 into 0.5 minus of 10 sin 60 into 2. This is plus 10 sin 60 into 2. Then minus of 10 cos 60 into 0.5. So ultimate solution shall come out as 43.32 kN meter. So unit of moment is kilonewton meter, and the value that comes out is 43.32 kilonewton meter. 43.32 kilonewton meter has a positive sign, so direction of rotation shall be in the clockwise direction. So this is how we are supposed to calculate moment with respect to the individual point and its location. If I happen to consider moment with respect to C, then C will be the origin. At origin again it will be 0, 0. And at 20 it will be 1, 0, and here it will be 2, 0.5, and as here it will be 0, 0.5. So that will be the coordinate when we consider moment with respect to C. This is how we are supposed to calculate moment with respect to the individual location and the point. So first and foremost point that we need to take care is, we need to consider the individual forces and its perpendicular distance. If you happen to have a x component force, I need to have a y coordinate. So likewise, if I have an y component force, I need to have an x coordinate. So y component force will be multiplied with x coordinate, whereas x component force will be multiplied with y coordinate. Depending upon the sign convention, if the sign convention, the net solution or the net expression sign convention comes out to be positive, which indicates direction of rotation of the lamina or the body will be in clockwise direction. Whereas if it comes out to be an minus, that means it rotates in the anticlockwise direction. So this is the solution how to find out the moment. Thank you. Have a nice day.